Alright guys, this is my first upload in a couple of days. First of all, I just want to say thanks for the feedback on my first COD video. That was quite good feedback on that. And I've gained about 20 subscribers since my last video, so that's been pretty good as well. And yeah, this is just going to be a squad builder. There aren't going to be any goals at the end because I just couldn't be... Well, not coming by, I just like forgot to record any gameplay for it because I don't really think ahead for that sort of thing. But yeah, the team of the season just been announced. I think it's the most consistent. Yeah, it's been announced that it's going to be out on May the 1st, which is tomorrow. So by the time I'll be uploading this, probably about 10:45. Well, probably a bit earlier. But it'll be out in a couple of hours. I don't know when it comes out on that day. I don't know if it's the start or like at 6 o'clock as normal. But yeah, going to get into the team now. It's just this team I've been using on my Mr. TBJ47 account. It's just been getting me through the divisions. I think I've won division. So yeah, in goal we have Sirigu. Decent player, 1,300 coins. Like the market crash has sort of hit now. It's going to hit again in a couple of days because team of the season. You could buy like when the first one hit in... We have Mariano. Everyone knows who he is, the cheap Brazilian 4-star skiller. 1,000 coins, 89 pace, and just all round amazing player. Then first centre back is going to be Entity. 1,200 coins, 74 pace, 67 defending. I've been switching out the centre backs with other League One because I think I could have anyone there. But I just prefer him because his silvers and quite a few silvers are overpowered in this game. So I thought I'd use him. Then going to the second centre back, we have the upgraded Nkalu. 900 coins, 79 pace, 82 defending, 77 heading. He isn't that much difference to his non upgraded, which is a 78 rated, but might as well. It's relatively the same price, even though none upgrades is a non-rare. Then left back's going to be Bedimo. Got him in a pack on my other account, just transferred him over just to complete the team. You can get him for about 800 coins. 82 pace, 73 shots, 71 dribbling, 76 defending, 75 heading. He's a really all-rounded player. I didn't really look it until I first looked at his stats like a couple of days ago. The only thing that really lets down is 60 shot, but he's a left back, so you don't really need to expect that from him. In the right centre mid, we have Marcus Assuncao. There is an inform for him. Well, it was like Team of the Week 3, I think. And he's gone down from 200 to 80k. But I didn't want to buy him because his free kicks, his inform, and his normal one are incredibly good. Inform's got like 97 free kick accuracy. And from a silver, that's just incredible. But it costs me 2,700 coins. He's gone down by about... he's gone down to 1/5 of his normal price. He's just a good player. The holding centre mid then is going to be Jan Envia. 3,500 coins, 4 goals in 20 games. Then Marcus Assuncao didn't get any goals. He did when I was playing against friends, but that didn't really count. But yeah, Envia, 77 pace, 63 shots, 77 passing, 75 dribbling, 81 defending. He is 6 foot, so that 68 heading doesn't really count because he does tower over a couple of strikers. And he's quite young. He's going to be quite a high-rated player on the next game because he's been playing well for Stade Rennais, starting nearly every game for them, I think. Then left centre mid is going to be McCoon. Really, he's got a decent shot. I think he's got better than that. I have played against a couple of friends on this, and he scored a couple of goals. Then left forward is going to be Ezequiel Lavezzi. Does only sell, scored three, played 3 games with him, but I have been using Alessandrini instead, and I scored 15 goals in 14 games with him. But Alessandrini's price has halved. His price will go back up when the French tournament comes out, and that's going to come out like a couple of weeks after the season. But Ezequiel Lavezzi, he's gone down to 6k now, which is incredible. 4-star skill, 4-star weak foot. 1 goal in 3 games, 93 pace, 77 shots, 74 passing, 90. On FIFA 11, I preferred him a lot more because he was a striker and he had 5-star skills. But on this one, and on the last one, FIFA 12 is only down 5-star. But I don't know why he hasn't got 5-star on this. It's like Messi, really. So really skillful in games, but does EA don't really show it in their cards. Then right forward is going to be Maikon Leite. His price has gone down, he's like halved, and his price will go back up after team of the season, because he's just... I do prefer Danilinho, but he's like twice his price, and Maikon Leite's got one like less stat on like... James is just an incredible player, 90 pace and 75 dribbling. His standout stats, and he's got 67 shot, but for a silver, you don't really expect much. The right forward. And the main man of the team is Lisandro Lopez, 17 goals in 17 games. These are all online. So I'll just show you. I think I did get relegated from Division. No, I'm still in Division. They're all games from this. This was the account that got hacked, so I had to restart it and like just carry on going with it. He doesn't look 5'9", he looks taller than that. As my mate's 5'9", he doesn't look as tall as he does. But yeah, this is the team. It's incredibly cheap. You could probably get it for about under 55k now easily. I'm doing quite a couple of cheap teams because I've got an account for because I'm going to be doing a massive pack opening for team of the season tomorrow for the first one. And I've got 7 million coins ready on one account and then 8,000 FIFA points on another, so look forward to that. But if you have enjoyed it and you want to see more squad builders and another series, please leave in the comment below, and please like, subscribe, and cheers.